All right, in this video, I'm going to continue adding fractions that have a common denominator, but we'll be working with mixed numbers. All right, so let's look at an example. 3 4/5 plus 6 2/5. Often people like to write this going up and down, so it doesn't matter which you put first. Let's say I put 6 2/5 plus 3 4/5. And either of these are an okay way to write the problem. So here's how we do it. Remember what 6 2/5 means? It means 6 plus 2/5, and this means 3 plus 4/5. So what we're gonna do is add the whole number of each together, which is 9, and then we're gonna add the fractional parts together. Well, I've got a common denominator, so they're fifths, and I have to do 2 plus 4, which is 6. Now the problem is, I have a mixed number and an improper fraction. We don't want to leave our answer that way. It's not in simplified form. So remember what this means? It means 9 plus 6/5. So watch how I'm going to write this. It's really 9 plus, well, 6/5 means, as a mixed number, 6 divided by 5, 1 1/5. So what we need to do is change that improper fraction to a mixed number so that I could add the 9 and 1 together. And that's correct. Now, I've written this as a mixed number. That's the natural way to do it if you start out with two mixed numbers. But you can change everything to improper fractions and work the problem that way as well. So let's say, what if I had done it that way? So I'm going to take it written in this horizontal format, and instead of adding the whole numbers and the fractions together, if you want, you can change these to improper fractions and do it, but you'll be working with larger denominators. So we have to change each of these to improper fractions. So 5 times 3 is 15 plus 4. That's the same as 19/5. And 6 times 5 is 30 plus 2 is 32/5. And now I've got to add 19 and 32. The denominator is the same, right? So I still have fifths. And 19 plus 32 is 51/5. Well, that is the same thing as 10 1/5, right? Both of these are reduced. One's written as a mixed number. One's written as an improper fraction. So if you would have done it either of these ways, you would get a correct answer. But if you were directed to write your answer as a mixed number and you did it this way where I change everything to improper fractions, you would then take 51/5 and divide, right, to get 10 1/5. So that's how we add mixed numbers that have a common denominator. You can either add the whole number parts, add the other parts, and then if you end up with an improper fraction, you have to make this little adjustment. Now, what's nice is when that doesn't happen, like if you have something like 3 2/9 plus 5 1/9, if I just add, I get 8, add the whole number parts, and then these have a common denominator, so I have 3/9. So this is not an improper fraction, but it isn't reduced. So in this case, we have to reduce the fraction. So we still have 8. And 3/9, you have to divide top and bottom by 3. That's going to give you 8 1/3. Now again, I'm writing my answer as a mixed number, which is natural since the problem originally had two mixed numbers. But you can rewrite each of these as improper fractions first if you prefer. So let's just do it that way. We have 9 times 3 is 27 plus 2. That's 29/9. Plus 9 times 5 is 45, plus 1, 46/9. I don't usually like to do it this way because I have to add bigger numbers together. So I have 29 and 46, that's 75/9. Now at this point, you notice it's an improper fraction and it's also not reduced. Okay, so you could just reduce it and leave your answer as an improper fraction, or you can change it to a mixed number first. All right, so let's do it both ways. Let's just reduce, dividing the top and bottom by 3. Hopefully you note that 3 goes into both of those numbers, and if not, you should at least ask yourself Does 2 go into both numbers? Does 3 go into both numbers, etc.? So that gives me 25 thirds. Well, that is the same thing as 8 and 1 third. Alternatively, when you got 75 ninths, if you didn't note that it reduced, you could have first changed it to a mixed number by saying, how many times does 9 go into 75? Well, it goes in 8 times, because 9 times 8 is 72, and 3 left over is 3 ninths. And then we're back to this problem we had, right? 8 and 3 ninths, which is 8 and 1 third. So it's like, you've got choices, but in the end, it's either going to be 8 and 1 third or 25 thirds. All right. How about if we were to add 2 and 5 sixths plus 3 and 5 sixths? All right, since they're both mixed numbers, it seems natural to just add the whole number parts together to me, 5. And common denominator, that's 10 sixths. All right, now what we have here with this 10 sixths, it's both not reduced and also it's an improper fraction. So we are going to have to do two things to deal with that. So, all right. Remember, this means 5 plus. You don't see it, but if you need to, put a little plus sign in there. All right, so what do we have? It depends if you want to reduce it first or if you want to write it as a mixed number first. I'm going to go ahead and write it as a mixed number. 10 divided by 6 is 1 and 4 sixths. Okay. And now I could add the 5 and 1 together to get 6. And 4 sixths, I'm going to reduce. So I'm doing two things. I'm adding the 5 and 1, and at the same time, I'm going to reduce the 4 sixths, dividing the top and bottom by 2 to get 6 and 2 thirds. Now, you could have done this problem again by just changing everything to improper fractions. If you find that easier, then go ahead and do it. So let's do it again. 2 and 5 sixths is an improper fraction. Would be 6 times 2, 12 plus 5 is 17 sixths. And 3 and 5 sixths is an improper fraction. Is 6 times 3, 18 plus 5 is 23 sixths. So let's say we had done the problem that way. So I'm adding 17 sixths plus 23 sixths. And that gives me 40 sixths. It's an improper fraction and it's not reduced. So remember, when that happens, you can either change it to an improper fraction first and then reduce, or reduce and then change to an improper fraction. Whatever's easiest for you. I'm going to reduce first because I note they're both even. 2 goes into both numbers, so I have 20 thirds. And then you could write your answer as 20 thirds, or you want to write it as a mixed number? 6 and 2 thirds. Last problem. Put it on pause and try this on your own. Write your answer as a mixed number for the final answer and have it make sure it's reduced. Okay, since it's written as mixed numbers, I'm going to go ahead and just add the whole number parts together. And the fractions, since they have a common denominator, I can write the 8 for the denominator, add 3 and 7 is 10. Right, but this is not reduced, it's also an improper fraction. You never want to mix a whole number with an improper fraction. So remember, that means 11 plus that. So this means 11 plus, well, you can change that to a mixed number, which is 1 and 2 eighths, which gives you 12. And, well, instead of writing 2 eighths, let's reduce it. 2 eighths reduces to 1 fourth. All right, that's one way to do it. Now, instead, when you were at 11 and 10 eighths, if you want, you could reduce it first. If you prefer, you could first write that as dividing top and bottom, 10 eighths plus 5 fourths, and then you could change that to 1 and 1 fourth. You'll still end up with 12 and 1 fourth. I know sometimes it confuses people because they want to be told what to do, but you know what? There are so many different ways, so many different paths to get the right answer. It's nice to have more than one way for different students. So if you can do it more than one way, great. But if you like doing it one method, go ahead and stick with that method. The last thing is you could have changed these to improper fractions and added as well. So 5 and 3 eighths is 43 eighths. 6 and 7 eighths is, let's see, 48 plus 7 is 55 eighths. And you could have done the problem that way, 98 eighths. And then reduce that to 49 fourths. And once you change it to a mixed number, you would end up with 12 and 1/4 again.